Hello guys, welcome to Creativebox. Today I am going to show you how to create a personal web page template in Photoshop. So we are going to create a personal portfolio web page template, and for this I'll be using two fonts, that are Open Sans and Roboto Condensed. If you already have that font, then you can skip the process I'm going to show. If you don't have that font, then you need to install that font in your PC. So for that, go to fontsquarel.com. The link is right here, and you can find the fonts here. Here you can find the font Open Sans. Go and download this font. And another font is Roboto Condensed, so search that font Roboto. Then download this font. Okay, once you have downloaded that font, you can find your fonts just like this, and after that right click and extract that font. Okay, and similarly for another font also, right click and extract here, and it doesn't matter, press yes to all. Okay, now select this font and press Ctrl C and search for fonts in your PC and open that. And here are all the fonts that are available in your PC, so press Ctrl V. So in my case the font is already present, so I'm not going to reinstall that, but in your case you need to install. Okay, after that select these fonts too and press Ctrl C. Go to the same folder of your computer and then press Ctrl V. And again, I have installed that font already, so this is appearing, so I don't want to install it again, so I'm going to press no. Okay, once you have pasted the font here, then you can access that font in your Photoshop. Now open Photoshop. Now go to file and press on new and give a name as you like. Okay, now set your width to 1400 pixel and height to 4000 pixel and resolution is 72 and everything is fine, and press OK. Okay, now press Ctrl 1 to zoom to actual size, and again press Ctrl minus so that we can see outside of our template. Now we are going to leave 15 pixel margin on both sides, so we need to create a guide, two guides. So go to view and select new guide and make sure you have selected vertical, and then type 15 pixel. Okay, again for another guide, go to new guide and set to 1385 and press OK. Okay, now we have two guides on our both sides. Now we can start creating further. First of all, I'm going to create section for home that will be displayed when the user enters in my web page. I'm going to use a background image and I will be putting my logo and some navigation here. So for that, create a new layer and select rectangular marquee tool and go to fixed size and set the height to about 700. Okay, now click on your screen and drag it. You can see I have some pink line above my document. If you don't have that, go to view and go to show and make sure that you have selected the smart guides. What this does is this helps you to make selections and to move anything layers. It shows you some guides, so make sure you have selected that. After that, create a guide. Okay, fine. Now press Ctrl D to deselect that selection. Now in this layer, go to normal and create a rectangle. Using rectangular marquee tool, make a selection this and fill it with any color, because we are going to use image in its place. And after that, we need an image to place it inside here. So to find an image, go to this website, pixabay.com. You can find free images right here and search for some images like you can find a lot of images. All these images are free, so I like this image and I'm going to use this image. So go here and click free download, and you can download this size. You don't need higher size than this, so okay, then you can download. Okay, once you have downloaded that, you can find that image, and after that, drag this image into your document and drop here and click OK. Now, in this layer, I'm going to place my image, so right click on your image, make sure your image is above the previous layer, and click on create clipping mask. Okay, now you can see that we have placed our image inside that selected region, and it's very good. Okay, the image is at perfect position. On the same area, I'm going to fill with some background color. So press Ctrl or hold Ctrl and click on this icon on this layer so that you get a selection of that layer. And now in this layer, in this new layer, select complete black color and press Alt Backspace to fill it. Okay, after you have filled that color, you can drop its opacity. So maybe 50% or maybe 70%. Okay, 70% looks good to me, and you may choose any percentage you like. So again, create a new layer. I'm going to create little more darker on the top portion, because here I'll be putting my logo and my navigation, so they are going to be in the white color. So I'm going to make it little darker, so to make them clearly visible. To make this, again create a selection about this and again fill it with the black color. Press Alt Backspace. Okay, press Ctrl D to deselect. I have already told you that. And now we are going to make this edge fade out, so click this icon on this layer to make a clipping layer mask, and go to your gradient tool and make sure that you have selected this gradient, that is black to transparent. So click here, and now make sure you are in the mask layer and click here and hold down shift key and drag it upward and leave. You can see that it is going to fade. So again, do that several times. Until you don't see hard edges. Okay, it's looking little bit good. So okay, now it's fine. You may drop down the opacity if you like, maybe about 80% or maybe about 70%. Okay, that's good. Now the background is complete. Now we need to insert logo and some navigation right here. So click new layer, and we need a logo. So I'm just going to create a simple logo. Choose your text tool, and I'm going to choose font impact, and I'm going to write my name is my logo. It is not visible because we have black color in black background, so change this color to white. Okay, now increase the font size about 30 or maybe even bigger, and this looks good. Okay, 48 pixel looks good to me. Now press Ctrl T in this layer and to transform it and drag it right here. Okay, press arrow key to move it up and down to adjust it properly. So this looks good to me. After that, I want to add some tagline here. So create a new layer, and I'm going to use font called Agency FB. These fonts are available in your PC. These are the default fonts, so you don't need to worry about these fonts. You can use any font to create your own logo, but I'm using this font. So I'm going to write some tagline, and I'll be using some font size about this. Okay, I'm not going to make it uppercase. So this looks very small. I'm going to increase the font size a little bit, 18 pixel. Press Ctrl 1 to zoom in, and let me see how it is looking. Okay, I'm going to increase font size a little bit more, 24 pixel. Press Ctrl T and move it right here. Okay, press arrow key, Ctrl T and arrow key to adjust as you want. Okay, hold your space key, and then you can see that you have little hand icon there, and you can drag and pan it anywhere you want. So this looks perfect. Now press Ctrl minus and drag it right here using holding your space key. Okay, now we need to create navigation right here. To create a navigation, go to text tool, and I have already told you that I'm going to use font Roboto Condensed and Open Sans for our entire web page except for this logo, because after all we will later save this logo as a image. So for navigation, I'm going to use Roboto Condensed font. So go here and type Roboto condensed. Okay, and press enter. Okay, I'm sorry, this font was applied here. Press Ctrl Z, create a new layer and type Roboto condensed. Okay, once you have got that font, change the font size. Change the font size to 20 pixel and make sure it is bold and set the text to uppercase. Okay, that's fine. Now we have already set up everything. Now you can create navigation. Home. Okay, press OK and create another. About, another portfolio, and last one is contact. Okay, but we need to align these all these in one line, so click one layer, top layer, and hold shift and click this layer and click on this icon and click this so that you can see it gets adjusted. Now we need another thing right here. We need a button to let the visitors download our CV. So I'm going to create a button right here. So create a new layer and right click here and click on rounded rectangle tool and make sure the radius is 4 pixel. Then click here and choose the height of about 36 pixel, border radius of 4, and press OK. Now you have got the button right here. Press Ctrl T and move it right here. Okay, double click here to change the background. Change the background to some blue color, like this blue. Okay, looks perfect. Press Ctrl 1 to zoom in little bit, hold space key to and slide. Okay, the button is good. We need to add some text inside the button. Go to new layer and go to text tool and make sure the color is white. Okay, I'm sorry, this color needs to be white. This is the text color, or this color. These both are same colors. This is your foreground color, so it doesn't matter. So make sure this is white color and write text download resume. Okay, this is little bit bigger, so I'm going to decrease its font. Okay, I'm not going to transform it uppercase, and also I'm going to remove it to regular, and I'm going to change its font size to about 14 pixel. Okay, 14 pixel looks good to me. Press Ctrl T and hold shift to slide in horizontal line. If you don't hold shift key, then it will go like that, but when you hold shift key, you can drag it in a straight line. So place it right here. But you can see my button is smaller than my text, so how can I increase my button size? Go to this layer, and if I press Ctrl T and transform my button, it will scale it. But the problem is the edge of my button gets distorted. So do not transform it directly, because we have used border radius here. So how I can do this is, in this layer select your pen tool and select add anchor point tool. Then inside your rectangle click and create a selection to the upper right corner, make so that your both of these edges are selected, and again press shift key and again drag and select these two. Now move with your arrow key as you want. So I think that may be good. Then press enter. Okay, now you can see the edge is not distorted, so it is very perfect. Now to place your text inside your button center vertically and horizontally, there is a very easy way. In this rectangle hold control and click here so that you get a selection. Then click on this text and go to this and click to align this. Okay, now it is perfectly aligned. Press Ctrl D to deselect. Now you can group this thing in single group because these are part of the button, so you can name this button. Okay, now the button is on the right perfectly, but you can see that there is not good spacing between these. So how I can manage this is, select these layers from home to contact and press Ctrl T and drag them. If you want to drag more, hold shift and press and it will drag more distance. Okay, now again portfolio seems to be little more closer, so I'm going to move it little bit onto the left. So in this layer press Ctrl T and move it holding shift key. Okay, perfect. Now press Ctrl minus and let's see how it looks. Okay, it looks good. Now you can see this is little bit downward, and maybe we can align this in one line so it will look good. So for this, select all these layers with this button tool and press Ctrl T and drag it maybe right here. You saw the pink line right here, that's so the center part of here, that is because we have selected the smart guides. So this is some benefit of smart guides. Okay, they are perfect. So I think this header part is completed. So select all these layers and press Ctrl Z to group them and give a name to HEADR header. Now I want to add some caption right here. So to make this, create a new layer and I'm going to type some text. Okay, I love coding. So I'm using the font Roboto Condensed and bold, and the color is white, but I'm going to increase its font size to about 60 pixels or maybe even bigger than that, maybe 72 pixels. Okay, that looks fine. Okay, I love coding. Okay, but I don't want this to be brighter, so I want to drop its opacity a little bit, or maybe up to 40%. Okay, maybe even less than that, 30%, or maybe even less, 20%. Okay, 20% looks good to me. Okay, I want to place this text inside this at the center and horizontally and vertically at the center. To do this, go to this layer, control and click on this layer to make the selection of this layer. Now make sure you are on this layer, then click this tool and click this and this, so it aligns its center. Now press Ctrl D to deselect everything. Okay, now I want to create another button right here, so that I will be placing some text in the button, like learn more about me, and when the user clicks this button, I want to slide my web page and take the user to about page, to the about section. So let's create a button. Create a new layer and select this rounded rectangle tool and click anywhere on the screen. And now make sure your width is 200 pixel and height is about 50 pixel and radius is 25 pixel. Okay, then press OK. Okay, you got a cool button. So I want to write some text inside my button, so but I want to change its background to complete black. Then create a new layer and use your text tool, and I'm going to use the font Open Sans. Because you have downloaded that font, you can find right here, and then choose regular and size is 14 pixel, and make sure you have choose uppercase. Then click right here and type your text. Okay, press Ctrl plus to zoom in little more to see it more clearly. Now we need to place our text in this button at the center. So the same thing, press hold Ctrl and click this icon right here, and on your text layer go to this icon and align this horizontally and vertically, and press Ctrl D to deselect. Now you can see that it is perfectly aligned inside this button. The text is perfectly aligned inside this button. Now shift click this layer to select both layers and Ctrl G to group them. Then name this button. Okay, I want to drag this button a little bit downward, maybe right here. So I don't want that button to have complete dark color. I want to reduce its opacity. So in this layer, drop down the opacity to about 40%. Okay, now looks good. And I want to use a border So right click in this layer and go to blending option and go to stroke and choose a size of about 2 pixel and change the color to white, then press OK and press OK. Okay, now the button looks good. Press Ctrl minus to zoom out. Okay, I want to create a guide at the center, so because I will be needing that guide for other work, so to create a guide at the center, what you can do is in this layer press Ctrl T and you can see that this is the central line, and click and drag guide from here and place it right at the center. Okay, and press OK. Now perfect. Then you can see the button is not at the center, so go to the button and press Ctrl T and place it at the center and maybe a little bit downward. Okay, perfect. This seems I want to move it a little bit upward. Okay, perfect. Now the home section is complete, so group all these into single group. So click on one layer and shift click on top layer and press Ctrl G to group them in a single group. This is our home section.